Hey friends, tonight we are hanging out at Disney's Boardwalk Resort and Jellyrolls, the dueling piano bar, has finally reopened. So I thought it'd be a nice night to have some drinks, watch some live entertainment, and maybe get a bite to eat. Todd English's Blue Zoo is doing Magical Dining Month, and I love their shake and bake french fries. Anywho's, let's go do this. A lot of people are excited for Jelly Rolls to reopen. It's really a fun atmosphere in there. Lots of good drinks, and like I said, it's a dueling piano bar, so they'll take a music request or song request, and it's just really fun, and I'm happy that it's reopening. And also, maybe later on, we'll do Atlantic Dance Hall. Jelly Rolls has always been one of my favorite places to come and hang out. It's also a good spot for cast members because they have cast member nights and cast member discounts. And I just love being at the Boardwalk no matter what. I mean, it is so beautiful here. It is just so beautiful here. I love everything. The music, the sound of the water, and just the atmosphere of the Boardwalk itself. Can you hear the Boardwalk music? Isn't it so amazing? Like, I could just spend hours sitting here. Also, if you take a look out there, you can see the top of Spaceship Earth right in the middle there. Isn't that cool? Oh, wow. So you're gonna be able to see Spaceship Earth all lit up from here. That really just hit me right now. That's gonna be amazing. I can't wait to see it. And since Jelly Rolls doesn't open till 7 o'clock, like I said, we have time to go grab something to eat. And I think we're going to actually walk right over to the Swan and Dolphin. I love actually going over there. That's very beautiful there. And it's Magical Dining Month. For Magical Dining Month, you get an appetizer, an entree, and a dessert for only $37 from a lot of restaurants here at like Disney World or on Disney property. They have a couple at Disney Springs, some of the resorts at Swan and Dolphin over here, and it's a really good deal. So yeah, might as well eat up a little bit before we hang out at Jelly Rolls. It is so beautiful out today. I am really enjoying just my walk over to the Swan and Dolphin. The sun is out, there's no clouds in the sky. I've got boats beeping at me. Hi friends. Ooh, well that's really exciting. Todd English's Blue Zoo is actually over on the dolphin side, so we're gonna head right on over there. But the swan side has some good restaurants, including Kimono's, which is a karaoke sushi bar, and that is a fun time as well. But I'm really excited to try the Magical Dining, and I'm hoping the shake and bake french fries is on the menu. That is something that really is cool, because I love shake and bake growing up, like shake and bake chicken, but french fries. So like, it is really awesome. We'll get them regardless anyway. Later on tonight, wait till you see the beautiful lights that they actually put on these trees. And I love the fountain. The fountain actually lights up as well. It's one of the biggest fountains, I think, on Disney property. It is very difficult to actually park at the Boardwalk Resort. So unless you are a resort guest or you have confirmed dining reservations, you're not going to be able to get in to go to Jelly Rolls. But if you park at the Swan and Dolphin, they have self-parking and you can pay to park here. Or if you are eating here, they will validate your parking for you. So that's what I did. And that's why we're going to Todd English's Blue Zoo, because then I don't have to pay to park and I get to walk right to the Boardwalk from here. And it is really only like a 2 minute walk. Like you go down this pathway right here and boom, the Boardwalk. You can actually see Epcot from here as well. But now it's time for our reservation. And I wore my blue mask because we're eating at Blue Zoo, so it would make sense. Todd English's Blue Zoo looks really cool on the inside. We're gonna actually head right on in. I love it so much in here. Doesn't it look like a bunch of fishes swimming right here? So trippy. Now we have made it to our table. We can take a look at the Magical Dining menu. It's like a separate little menu they have here. And a lot of good offerings and choices. And whether or not they have the shake and bake french fries on there, we're still gonna get them because I really, really wanna show you them. Here is a look at the Magical Dining menu. And like I said, $37 and you get to pick one appetizer, one entree, and one dessert. And I think I'm gonna get the pork belly bao bun, the crispy skin chicken, and maybe a root beer float. That sounds really interesting, right? $37, you can't go wrong with that. They have their own custom Blue Zoo dinner napkins. I feel like that is very fancy. This is gonna have to go on my lap here. Perfect. On top of the appetizer, entree, and dessert, they also give you a bread service with the Magical Dining. So you get a lot of food for $37. Like I'm really shocked. And also, I'm really impressed how everything says Blue Zoo on it. They have a little Blue Zoo bread basket. That sounds funny, a Blue Zoo bread basket. But look at that, the bread actually looks really good. It's a bunch of different bread too. So it's not just the same one. Oh wow, is that a bacon jam bread down there? Or an onion one? Oh boy, I'm loving it. This is gonna be good. This one looks like a cheese bread. Very thin, like paper thin. I'm gonna probably like this though. We'll try it. It tastes like a cheesy flatbread. It's actually really delicious, and I'm excited for this. This is definitely an onion bread, and it's very soft, and it looks amazing. Look at that. Oh, wow. That's the winner. The bread service here is really something you don't want to sleep on, and it comes with a fennel seed butter, too. And look at that. Look how perfectly, like, smooth the top of the butter is. Like, I give that a 10 out of 10 right there. Here is a look at the regular menu, and they have a lot of good offerings. I hear the steak is really good here, but that's not on the Magical Dining Month menu. But take a look at the sides. Right there they are. The shake and bake french fries, and they also have tempura green beans, which actually sound amazing. So if I get two sides with my chicken, I might get those too. That would be great. Holy moly, they just brought over the bao buns, and I thought I was getting a bao bun, but they gave me three bao buns, and that's how it's served normally. And that's amazing. Wow, so much food. Holy moly. Look at that. Isn't that so cool? They look so good too. And there's actually like a whole entire like pork belly in each one of them. Like they have pork belly, pork belly, pork belly. Blown away by that. I think we're just gonna dive right on in here. But don't they look so amazing? That is literally the best bao bun I've ever had. The pork belly is like on point, like nothing I've seen before. They definitely sear it too, because it has a little crispiness to it, but I am impressed. If this is just a start, I'm sure the entree is gonna be amazing. For real, I might actually come back here just for these. They are so, so good. Like, top notch, I say. And take a look at this. Wow, that chicken looks amazing. And it comes with arugula salad and warm bread. But here are the shake and bake french fries. These are the things I love most. Look, you can see the rosemary, you can see the cheese on there. And honestly, I didn't think they'd give me such big like thing. I asked for a side of them, and I also got a side of tempura green beans. And look at the size of this. I'm not gonna be able to eat all that. Like, that is a huge portion for the price that you're paying here. I mean, wow, I'm kind of blown away by it. First things first, the shake and bake french fries. And you can actually see the seasoning on there. I'll shake some off. Look at that. You can see it coming right off. And these are so amazing. So here we go. Now I think we'll dive in to the chicken, and it looks perfect, right? I bet you it's gonna be super crispy. And also the green beans. Like, this is so much food, holy moly. And they also give you a little chicken au jus as well. So maybe we'll put a little bit of this on that. We're just gonna go right on in on the chicken. Ooh, the chicken is great, but I really can't get enough of these shake and bake french fries. And I found a little trick here. Just a little bit of that. Perfect. They really do give you so much. I don't think I can finish all this. I mean, these two sides, normally these are like full sides, but I got one side instead. So I have to pay an additional price of like $9 for the side. But just one of them's good enough. I didn't think they were gonna be this huge. I mean, this is like a whole tin full. But man, those shake and bake french fries, much too good. Now I think it's time for dessert, and I'm going with the root beer float. I feel like I haven't had one of those in such a long time, and yeah, I think it would be good with this. Well, if that ain't the fanciest looking root beer float I have ever seen. Holy moly. And it comes with a metal straw too. Oop.
I can't wait to try this now. It's got a little metal straw in it.
That is amazing. Holy moly.
The cream on top of this is just so good. This is honestly one of the best root beer floats I've ever had. I really love it.
And now I think it's time we get moving along so we can get over to Jellyrolls, but I really love that root beer float and the shake and bake fries. Those were so amazing. The chicken wasn't like my favorite thing. I think it was good because it was $37 for everything together, but if I didn't get the magical dining like meal package, my whole entire like experience would have cost me like $60, $70 because the chicken alone was $30. So for $7 more, I got the appetizer, dessert, and bread. And I don't know, I don't think I would be happy if I paid $30 for that chicken. But the shake and bake French, the shake and bake fries really made up for everything. So I think we're gonna head back to the boardwalk. As I'm making my way back over to the boardwalk, the lights aren't on yet. Hopefully they'll be on by the time we get done, because we're gonna have to come back this way because we parked over here. But take a look at the moon up there. Oh, never mind, the moon is gone. The clouds kind of covered it up. I can't believe how dark it got so quick. Like, we were only in there for maybe an hour and 20 minutes, and it's already just about 7:30, so hopefully there wasn't a line again in Jellyrolls. It could be a very popular spot, so we might have to be waiting for a while outside. And it looks like there is a little bit of a line to actually get in, and it just opened. So I'm sure as it gets later in the night, it's gonna be more busy in there, and it'll probably hit capacity, so you might have to wait outside, but maybe we won't have to wait long. This is strictly 21 and over, and like I said, I'm very excited. We're about to go in soon, and oh, I can see the reflection of Spaceship Earth in the window. Look at that. Do you see Spaceship Earth over there doing the beacons of magic? It's so pretty. As we're about to head in, they're actually giving out little postcards of Jellyrolls. Look at that. That's really cool. I don't know if they do this all the time or if they're just doing it for their grand reopening, but I like it. I will cherish this. It is $15 to get in, and then once you get in, you get a little stamp or a wristband, and they'll let you come in and out as you want for the rest of the night. And masks are required unless you're actively eating or drinking, which they do have free popcorn in here, so that's always good. There we go. We're all stamped up and ready to go in now.
Hi there. Welcome in.
Thank you. Looks like the show has not started yet, but wow, I am so excited to be back. We got almost a full house in here. It usually sometimes gets a little bit rowdy in here with dancing, but I'm not sure how that's gonna go now since it just reopened, and they have two bars, one's over there, and then the other one's over here. So I think we'll get ourselves a drink and then maybe put in a song request. Doesn't look like they started up the popcorn yet, but I got myself a Bud Light. And I think I'm gonna sit in this little corner right here next to the stage. I got my hat holding down the spot. If you wanna get a table like close to the stage, you definitely have to get here early. If you guys have ever been to any other dueling piano bar, basically you write your song request on a piece of paper and you give it to the performer or put it on the piano with a tip, and they'll try to sing it throughout the night. And I have to think which one I'm gonna request.
Yeah, sure.
Oh!
Outside for a second because I was looking out the window and I realized the fireworks are going off. And how cool is that? Look at that. Isn't that beautiful? Like, I was in there and I seen the fireworks from the window and I was like, holy moly, you can see Harmonious from the boardwalk. And I think it was beautiful. So that was really cool to see the fireworks actually from the boardwalk as well. And instead of hopping back into Jellyrolls, I think I'll head over to the Atlantic Dance Hall and check that out and show you guys. That's another fun spot. There's no cover charge, cheap drinks, but it's not as fun and upbeat as Jellyrolls. Like, Jellyrolls is a great time. Like, I love it in there, and it hasn't changed much. Like, people are still getting up on stage, they're dancing, they're singing, and it's kind of like the old Jellyrolls that I remember. So we'll hop right from Jellyrolls over to the Atlantic Dance Hall, and this is open till 1 a.m. Holy moly, Thursdays through Sundays, and it's a really fun time. Oh yeah, look at it in here. So you can see the Atlantic Dance Hall is a very loud environment, a lot of dancing and people just cutting loose and having fun on vacation. But my favorite thing about the Atlantic Dance Hall is the patio outside where we are right now. It is so peaceful and beautiful to be standing out here. Look at this, isn't it so nice? I love just being out here, tucked into the water, because that's what you are. You're tucked into the water away from the boardwalk, and it's just so nice. Got some ducks over there, and I could spend the whole night out here actually instead of being in there. I wanted to show you guys a lot more inside the dance club, but I really can't show you much because there's a lot of loud music and the screens and everyone's just dancing and having fun. And plus, Epcot is closing, so the boardwalk is about to get very busy. Look, you can actually see just the rows of crowds just coming in right now. So if you plan on coming here to like hang out, definitely come before Epcot closes. And with that, I think we are done here today. What a fun little adventure we had today. Had a nice little dinner, got to hang out at the boardwalk, got to check out Jellyrolls and welcome it back. And I love seeing people so excited about things returning. And the nightlife here is like so fun. Like, people are having a great time. And it's nice to see it back to normal almost. Soon they'll be bringing back the performers on the boardwalk, because that's one thing that's missing. I feel like if they brought that back during the day, it'll make it more festive for people to come and enjoy and walk around. But yeah, like I said, I think we're gonna call it a night. So I hope you enjoyed the video. I enjoyed making it. We'll see you next time. Bye. Oh, look at this. Before we leave, they have the lights on the trees finally, so I can show you guys like I was talking about before. It's so pretty.